Men and brethren, we are not drunken, as you are thinking. This is that which was spoken of by Joel the prophet when he said, in the last days the Lord would pour out his spirit upon all flesh. Your sons and your daughters would receive this gift. And today it is available to you and to future generations. For everyone who calls upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. Men of Israel, listen to this. Jesus of Nazareth was a man accredited by God to you by miracles, wonders, and signs, which God did among you through him, as you yourselves know. This man was handed over to you by God's set purpose and foreknowledge, and you, by the help of wicked men, put him to death by nailing him to the cross. They go on and buried Jesus. In a sepulchre of clay they laid him, killing off the only hope they'd known. They wrapped him in a sheet of white and left him to the racks of time and sealed him from the sunlight with a stone. His followers were angry 'cause we thought that he betrayed our trust. We hid ourselves in sorrow from the grave, while the Roman guards policed the tomb from morning through the midnight watch to keep his friends from snatching him away. Three cruel days and three cruel nights he stayed inside the earth and let them think that they had beaten down his cause. The Pharisees and Sadducees were glad his voice was silenced as they took front stage to everyone's applause. God had not forsaken his own son. The hour of vindication dawned. The breath of life